For the very first year, Juneteenth is now an official state holiday in Massachusetts. While Juneteenth started out a century and a half ago as a Texan holiday, it's been celebrated by Black Americans here in the Northeast for generations. Recognized on June 19, the holiday commemorates the day that the last formerly enslaved people were told they were free, in 1865. After last year's largely virtual Juneteenth celebrations due to the pandemic, communities all across the region are getting ready to observe the holiday with flag-raising ceremonies, live performances, barbecues, art, and reunions of friends and family. Below are a few Juneteenth parties happening on the North Shore throughout the next week, many of them first annual celebrations. Lynn. The North Shore Juneteenth Association will hold a lively event this Saturday from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m. at the Lynn Museum's courtyard. At their free Juneteenth Festival, the association welcomes local performers like dancers and musicians along with food vendors cooking up soul food. The event will also include opportunities to shop from local Black-owned vendors and learn more about the history of Juneteenth. When? Saturday, June 19, 1, 5 p.m. Where? Lynn Museum. Link. Salem. The Artful Life is collaborating with the North Shore Juneteenth Association for an event called Celebrating Black Voices, Collaborative Collage and Book Fair. On Saturday, June 26, this drop-in event will be split between the two floors of the Artful Life Counseling Center and Studio in Salem. The first floor will be a book fair, with children's books by Black authors curated by Copper Dog Books, along with tables featuring local Black artists. The second floor plays host to a collaborative collage, in which all guests are encouraged to participate. The collage pays homage to Black American collage artist Romare Bearden. When? Saturday, June 26, 12, 5 p.m. Where? Artful Life Counseling Center and Studio, Salem. Link, fb.me1sxgrjry. On Saturday, Juneteenth, the Salem Commons will host a demonstration called Remembering Juneteenth, in which participants will gather to remember lost Black and brown lives, especially those who have lost their lives in the pursuit of justice and equality. When? Saturday, June 19, 7:30-8:30 p.m. Where? Salem Commons. Link, fb.me17beefs2w. Read, Nicole McLean, founder of the North Shore Juneteenth Association. Andover. Merrimack Valley Black and Brown Voices has organized a Juneteenth block party this weekend, full of music, dancing, food, and joy. The second annual celebration will take place at Doherty Field in Andover on Saturday evening. You can expect activities like face painting and a bouncy house, art and crafts vendors, live performers, and some delicious Haitian barbecue catering. Be sure to RSVP at the link below. When? Saturday, June 19, 5, 8 p.m. Where? Doherty Field, Andover. Link, fb.me2xrjv2o. Swampscott. Swampscott holds its first ever Juneteenth celebration tomorrow, June 17. The traditional Juneteenth event welcomes all community members and includes a flag raising, live music, food, speakers, yard games, and more. When? Thursday, June 17, 1 p.m. Where? Swampscott Town Hall. Link, fb.me1sjeebd. Lowell. The city of Lowell will hold a Juneteenth celebration with a flag raising at Lowell City Hall on Saturday at 9 a.m. Lowell Mayor Leahy will be joined by other city officials for this first annual event. When? Saturday, June 19, 9 a.m. Where? Lowell City Hall. Link, fb.me.sibay. Everett. Tomorrow, June 17, at 11 a.m., Everett will also host its first Juneteenth flag raising in collaboration with the North Shore Juneteenth Association. The event will include dance and poetry performances along with refreshments. Speakers include Everett Mayor DeMaria, North Shore Juneteenth Association President Nicole McLean, and State Senator Salvador Domenico. When? Thursday, June 17, 11 a.m. Where? Everett City Hall. Link. Washington, the United States will soon have a new federal holiday commemorating the end of slavery. The House voted 415-14 Wednesday to make Juneteenth, or June 19th, the 12th federal holiday. The bill now goes to President Joe Biden's desk, and he is expected to sign it into law. Juneteenth commemorates June 19, 1865, when Union soldiers brought the news of freedom to enslaved black people in Galveston, Texas, 2 months after the Confederacy had surrendered. That was also about 2 years after the Emancipation Proclamation freed slaves in the southern states. It's the first new federal holiday since Martin Luther King Jr. Day was created in 1983. Our federal holidays are purposely few in number and recognize the most important milestones, said Rep. Carolyn Maloney. D-N.Y. I cannot think of a more important milestone to commemorate than the end of slavery in the United States. Rep. Sheila Jackson Lee, D. Texas, speaking next to a large poster of a black man whose back bore massive scarring from being whipped, said she would be in Galveston this Saturday to celebrate along with Republican Sen. John Cornyn of Texas. Can you imagine? Said the rather short Jackson Lee. I will be standing maybe taller than Sen. Cornyn, forgive me for that, because it will be such an elevation of joy. The Senate passed the bill a day earlier under a unanimous consent agreement that expedites the process for considering legislation. It takes just one senator's objection to block such agreements. Please, let us do as the Senate. Vote unanimously for passage, Rep. David Scott, D. Gaw, pleaded with his colleagues. The vote comes as lawmakers struggle to overcome divisions on police reform legislation following the killing of George Floyd by police and as Republican state legislators push what experts say is an unprecedented number of bills aimed at restricting access to the ballot box. While Republicans say the goal is to prevent voter fraud, Democrats contend that the measures are aimed at undermining minority voting rights. Several members of the Congressional Black Caucus took to the floor to speak in favor of the bill. Rep. Bonnie Watson Coleman, D-N.J., said she viewed Juneteenth as a commemoration rather than a celebration because it represented something that was delayed in happening. It also reminds me of what we don't have today, she said. And that is full access to justice, freedom and equality. All these are often in short supply as it relates to the black community. The bill was sponsored by Sen. Edward Markey, D-Mass, and had 60 co-sponsors. Democratic leaders moved quickly to bring the bill to the House floor after the Senate's vote the day before. Some Republican lawmakers opposed the effort. Rep. Matt Rosendale, Armand, said creating the federal holiday was an effort to celebrate identity politics. Since I believe in treating everyone equally, regardless of race, and that we should be focused on what unites us rather than our differences, I will vote no, he said in a press release. The vast majority of states recognize Juneteenth as a holiday or have an official observance of the day, and most states hold celebrations. Juneteenth is a paid holiday for state employees in Texas, New York, Virginia, and Washington. Under the legislation, the federal holiday would be known as Juneteenth National Independence Day. Rep. Clay Higgins, R. Law, said that he would vote for the bill and that he supported the establishment of a federal holiday. But he was upset that the name of the holiday included the word independence rather than emancipation. Why would the Democrats want to politicize this by co-opting the name of our sacred holiday of Independence Day? Higgins asked. Rep. Brenda Lawrence, D. Mitch, replied, I want to say to my white colleagues on the other side, getting your independence from being enslaved in a country is different from a country getting independence to rule themselves. She added, we have a responsibility to teach every generation of black and white Americans the pride of a people who have survived, endured and succeeded in these United States of America despite slavery. The 14 House Republicans who voted against the bill were Andy Biggs of Arizona, Mo Brooks of Alabama, Andrew Clyde of Georgia, Scott Descharlais of Tennessee, Paul Gosar of Arizona, Ronnie Jackson of Texas, Doug LaMalfa of California, Thomas Massey of Kentucky, Thom McClintock of California, Ralph Norman of South Carolina, Mike Rogers of Alabama, Rosendale of Montana, Chip Roy of Texas and Tom Tiffany of Wisconsin.